Good morning, Shalom everyone. Welcome to Devotion from Nation. After we have off for the 10th day for rest and concentrate and a focus for every church program and also quality time with our family for start new journey in the 2021. And now we come back again to you, to all of you, to share in the Devotion from Nation. I'm so glad to be here. And then I hope all of you always in God's protection from this place. This morning, I pray for all of you, all the people in Asia, USA or Australia and any nation. I pray for all of you in God's protection. Stay healthy and keep growing strong in everything, in every area in your life. This morning, I want to try to sharing in Devotion from Nation in English. Because some people from other nation ask me to sharing in English because they don't understand about the language. But this morning, I'm trying to sharing in English because we just want to encourage all the people in many nations. It doesn't matter, be honest with you, my English is very limited, but I believe in God. It doesn't matter my limitation English can be, and I believe in God. My limitation will become unlimited. I also encourage to all my friends in Devotion from Nation or wherever and who wanna sharing good news to all the nation, don't be shy. Because just share it. It doesn't matter, we have a limitation, maybe in English, maybe in language, maybe in speaking, in everything. Just sharing and depend on the Lord and the Holy Spirit and also believe in Christ, our limitation will become unlimited. For me personally, it's not easy to do this. I learned so hard, but I'm personally very appreciative for all my friends in from Philippines, Singapore, Korea, US, Australia, and Holland and some nation because they have the desire to hear the news. The good news from Devotion from the Nation, but they don't understand in Indonesian language. That's why, see, they ask me, they text me about please, maybe next time can sharing in English. But this morning, by the grace of God, and I'm trying to do my best to all of you, because my purpose, because my goal, my desire, the only one, finally, every people, every nation can hear the news and got encouragement from Devotion from Nation. And also we can learn good things from many pastor and leader from other nation in Devotion from Nation. And I believe this is our good things we can do together and bless each other from nation to the nation. God bless you. This morning, I just want to share a little bit about the God timings to all of you, because I believe we must really understand about God timings. Maybe we already praying so long time, we're waiting for the God promises in our life, maybe in our business, in our family, but the promises never become the reality. Maybe someday you are praying and then God give you the vision, God spoke to you about the promises, and you very excited. The first you are receive the word from the Lord, and maybe you receive the word, the prophesy from other people, other pastor, and then you are very excited to first. The first you are receive the word, and then you are very excited every single day. You are working, you are do something, and then one day after you are waiting so long. But the promises never come into your life, into your family, into your business. And then you are become desperate. You become say, wow, I'm boring and anything. You know, you must understand the principle of the God timings. This morning, I want to share to you about the principle of God timing. And I believe and I hope you will be blessed. And This morning you are already got the word from the Lord for your family, for the future, and especially for the 2021. And so many prophesy you got, and then you say, wow, I'm very excited for 2021. And you are awaiting the God promises in the 2021. I just want to put the foundation to all of you about the principle God timing. And I believe and I hope you will be got the encouragement, and then you also got the blessing about the principle of God timing. The number one, the first principle of God timing you must understand is that God timing is always perfect. Believe me, God never early and never late, but always on time. In all my life, you know, in the 2020, you know, so many things I waiting God promises in my life, in my family. And somehow, you know, maybe we say, Lord, why so long? Why we are waiting so long for your promises to for my family, for my ministry? And then, you know, I God teach me about the principle of God timing. And I learned many, many things, many time about God timings. And I got the conclusion about God timing. The first is His timing is always perfect. Listen, God never early, never late, but always on time. We must know our timing is not God timing. Somehow we ask the Lord and say, Lord, you must do this now. Believe me, listen, God timing is not our timing. Maybe for us, this is the best timing, Lord, you must answer my prayer. This is the best time for me. Believe me, listen, God timing is not our timing. But you must believe one thing, God timing is always perfect. We are timing, somehow many things is fail, it's not perfect. But we must trust Him because His timing is always perfect. That's why this is a principle you must really understand in your life. God timing is always perfect. If you believe this, you must trust, put your trust to Him. And you know, you must put your trust in Him because His timing is always perfect. Maybe you are now, in this morning, you are waiting the God promises in your life. And you say, Lord, I already desperate. I already give up. Because why, Lord, so long I must waiting for your promises? But I just want to encourage you again. Believe me, God timing is always perfect. He know what is the best for you. He know when He must He must answer your praying. He knows when He will bless you. He will do something in your life. Give you the breakthrough. Give you the what you are asking to the Lord. Believe me, God timing is always perfect. In the God perfect timing, does two things. The first is grow our faith. You know, in this situation, waiting on the God timing, you know, God have the purpose why we are waiting so long. Because in the waiting time, it's growing our faith. You must really understand in the waiting on the promises of the Lord, many times you will see and know and understand after that. You will see your faith now is growing more and more and more because you know God timing is always perfect in your life. And then also you must really understand at the right time, God will provide your need. Believe me, in many testimony in my family, you know, we are waiting on the God promises, but at the end of the day, He always provide you. Because you know why? Because He will provide all you need. That's why believe Him and trust. Put your heart to trust His way and His timing. Because His timing is always perfect. The number two you must know, but the principle of God timing, you must remember this. God always has the final say. This is the second and the last point I want to share to you about two things about God timing. This is very powerful. So bless me and bless my life. Because the Lord said to me, son, my timing is always perfect. And number two, God always has the final say. You know, no matter how terrible, no matter how impossible in this situation, in every situation, God, it doesn't matter how do you feel, God always have the final say. You know, Lazarus was dead, and then Maria said, Jesus, if you have in here, my brother Lazarus is not dead. You know, sometimes, you know, in this the journey of faith in your life, so many things, you know, it's not only the people from outside, maybe in our family, they also saying something. But believe me, God always has the final say. It doesn't matter that Lazarus was dead first day, God always has the final say. At the end of the day, you know every the story of the Lazarus. It doesn't matter, Maria say, Jesus, if you in there, Lazarus is not dead. But believe me, God always has the final say. And what they do, what he do in the last time is come to the tomb and then rise Lazarus from the dead. That's what I believe. In Jesus will take wash what has died in you and rise it from the dead. You know, the world put a period after Jesus' crucifixion and died, but God always has the final say. On the third day, everybody know, on the third day, Sunday morning, God raised Jesus from the dead and he is alive. Because of Jesus Christ's death, and the grave no longer have the last day in your life. Jesus has the last day, and because he lives, in if you trust in him and put your life in his hand, you are going to life too. Because he always has the final say. This morning, it doesn't matter what people talking about you, talking about your future, saying something about bad things about your future, your family, your ministry. Believe me, God always has the final say. And he can rise up your vision. It doesn't matter already die. This morning, 2021, I believe God will rise up again the new vision. And God will bring you in the new journey, new glory, and new level of the faith. And God will increase your faith and bring you in the new level of glory. And you will see the glory of God upon you. And because God has the final say in your life. This morning, it doesn't matter if people say, you're dying, your future is dying, your family is dying, you will be dying because of the sick. I saying to you this morning, Jesus has the final say to you. He say is the restoration. He say to you, everything is possible to you. He's saying to you, you will alive if you believe him. I believe he will give you a breakthrough glory, and he will bring you to the next level of glory. He will bless you with abundance and overflowing in every area in your life. Come on, we lift up our hand and pray. Father in heaven, we thank you for this morning. Thank you for your God timings, for my family, for our ministry, for our church, and for our future, God. We believe God timing is always perfect in every area in our life. And we believe also, God, you have the final say, and you will say the breakthrough, healing, a blessing to our family, to our ministry, and to our future, oh God. Lord, this morning I speak life, I speak breakthrough, I speak healing, and I speak restoration to all your people, because that is your final say to us. Lord, we surrender to you in 2021, all our life, all our future, our ministry. We don't believe what the people saying about us, about our family, but we believe you has the final say, and you will see a life, breakthrough, healing, and restoration to all of us. In Jesus' name, we receive, Lord, and we give thanks to you and we glorify you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. God bless you and have a great day. And come on, we start with the Jesus in this year 2020 with Jesus. I pray from this place, God will bless you. And believe me, God's timing is always perfect for your future and for your family. God bless you and see you again in next devotion.